Hello everyone, Mauro here. In this video, we're going to look at the Gemini chatbot AI coming to Chrome. So similar to Copilot on Microsoft Edge, Google is now bringing its Gemini AI to Chrome. And it is quietly adding an option to bring the chatbot to the taskbar on Windows 11. Okay, let's dive into the new AI integration that is coming soon for Google Chrome users. But before we start, make sure to subscribe and hit the like button. It helps me a lot to grow the channel and continue with this project. Also, check out my website for more tutorials and related tech news. Okay, so this is how the integration appears in Chrome with this button at the top right. And to access it, you just need to click it, and then this flyout interface will appear. And from here, you can interact with Gemini like you would on gemini.google.com or when using the add Gemini on the address bar. So for example, right here, we can ask Gemini how to download the Windows 11 ISO. And then we just press enter to submit the question. And here the AI is creating the answer. However, things turn a little bit different when we click the share the current page. Now, when you do that, you will be allowing Gemini access to the page you're currently viewing. And from here, you can ask follow-up questions about that particular page. So let's say, give me a summary of the current page. And as you can see, now Gemini was able to look into the page and give us some information. And this is very similar on how Copilot works on Microsoft Edge. Just remember that everything you do in Gemini on Google Chrome will be sent and processed by Google. From this interface, you can access this menu. And from here, you can start a new chat, view your recent chats, and you can continue on the web, and that will just open Google Gemini on a different tab. You can also access the Chrome settings, more specifically for the Gemini experience. Another interesting feature is that you can use the Gemini Live feature, and you have to do that by clicking this button right here. And of course, using the Live feature allows you to interact with Gemini using voice instead of text. If you want to switch to text mode, just click this button. It is important to know that this is a floating interface, so you can move it around and you can always close it right here. Another interesting aspect about the Gemini integration is the option that allows you to access the chatbot from the taskbar, which is basically an option to compete with Copilot. And I'm going to show you that in just a minute. Now, it is important to know that this feature is optional, and when you get it on your browser, you will get a notification to enable it. Currently, this feature is available for the latest preview of Chrome on the beta, dev, and community channels. Also, it is only available for select users in the US using the English language in the browser. In my case, I was able to access the chatbot in the Canary channel. In addition, you have to be logged in with your Google account, but that is not a surprise. Okay, Gemini in Chrome has a few options that you can configure from the settings. And to do that, we need to open settings. And before we open the page, I just want to show you that the Gemini option is also available from the context menu. From here, we go to settings. Then we go to AI innovations. And from here, if the feature is available to you, you will see Gemini in Chrome. And on this page, that's where you can configure the available options. One of the options that caught my attention is this one, that when you turn it on, it allows you to show the Gemini in the system tray, and you can turn on a keyboard shortcut to access the Gemini assistant from the taskbar on Windows 11. And as you can see, when I turn this on, now Gemini is right here on the bottom right corner. And even if we close the browser, we can access Gemini right here. And by default, you will pick up where you left off with the chatbot. You can always clear the interface by using the start a new chat option. Remember, this is still in preview, so there are a lot of things that are not working correctly and the interface needs a little more tweaking. However, we can see that Google is slowly trying to slip into the Windows 11 desktop, which is the territory for Copilot. So if we open both apps side by side, we can see that both apps are pretty similar and they offer pretty much the same technology. So now Microsoft should be worried about this. We'll see. Now, one thing that I wanted to point out is that if you don't want the access to Gemini, you can unpin it from the top right by right-clicking and selecting the unpin option. However, it appears that you cannot actually remove Gemini completely from the browser because you can still access it from the context menu. And if we go to the settings, we won't find an option to turn off the experience. Yes, you can turn off some of the features, even the microphone and hear the page content sharing, but there isn't an option to actually remove Gemini from the browser. So it's something to consider for those who are concerned about privacy moving forward when using Google Chrome. And that's it. That was an early look at the Gemini integration into Google Chrome for Windows 11 users. Let me know in the comments what you think about this feature and if you will be using it. Like the video, share it, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done that yet, and I just hope this video was informative for you, and I would like to thank you for viewing.